What's up, everybody? Especially you Donald Trump supporters, Twitter people out there. I want to talk to you guys a little bit about immigration, illegal immigration, all right? And why I think Donald Trump's policy is just pretty much very stupid and makes no sense. Now, a lot of you guys say, why aren't you illegals do it the legal way? There's a legal way. Why not do it the legal way? I'll tell you why we don't do it the legal way, see? Yes, there is a legal way. There's plenty of legal ways, but they're very impossible to accomplish. Now, I was 4 years old, five, when they took me to the U.S. by force. I mean, it wasn't really my choice, right? It was my parents who wanted a better opportunity for me, so they decided to take me out there. So I went out there, I learned the language, I did what I had to do, did my school, wanted to join the military, boom, rejected. Wanted to get a job, boom, rejected. Wanted to go to watch a rated R movie, nope, not possible. So all my options were pretty much closed. Couldn't go to university, couldn't go to the army. So what the hell could I do? Nothing, there was nothing for me to do. I was pretty much a ghost. Wasn't able to get a summer job and I didn't want to do a shit job. I didn't want to work as a janitor or picking onion for the rest of my life. So I wanted to study. I wanted to find a way to study. So in 2003, I decided to leave. Go back to Mexico, do it the legal way. Just like you guys are suggesting we do. Just like Donald Trump wants 11 million people to do. So yeah, I went back to Mexico with the idea of studying and then coming back, visiting my family, right? Well, wrong. So go to school. Then I said, all right, I'm gonna go try to get a visa, a visitor's visa, just so I can visit my family. Boom, no, you're not eligible. Please continue your school. Once you're done with the school, then come back and we'll give you a visa. All right, so I did that. I went back, I finished my university. That's 4 years, almost 5 years of architecture. Came back with a job and they said, no, you're not eligible. You need to have property, own something, have money in your bank account, so we know that you're not going to stay in the US. Yeah, it makes sense. All right, so I went back, got a better job. Actually, I owned my own construction company. I was building houses. I owned two cars. I owned an apartment and I was on the way to owning another business. Went back and they said, nope. Not eligible. You need to get married. Okay, I'll get married. So I went back, got married, had a daughter, had traveled the world pretty much. I've been to many countries. Went back, nope, not eligible once again. This time they told me, well, you have properties in Mexico. You could easily rent them and live in the US. Now, why would I do that? If I'm doing okay in Mexico, why would I do that? I just want to visit my family. But no, their legal way, it's not exactly as functional as you guys would think. So again, they told me I was not eligible. Went back, tried again, and the last time. And I'm pretty happy about this lady because she finally made me realize there was no possible way for me to ever get it. So she said, you know what, I'm gonna be honest with you. You're not eligible and you're never gonna be eligible. So I suggest you stop trying. Wait a minute, wait. I'm not eligible ever? It because I was out there when I was 5 years old. I mean, I didn't go there by my own decision, right? But I'm being punished for it. Now I can't see my family. So it's been decades since I see my mom. So thanks a lot, legal way. But yeah, this lady told me how to do it. She said, yep, it's not gonna work. Stop doing it, stop trying. You should try getting a citizenship. It's probably easier. Your brothers, your siblings can, they can try to get you into a citizenship program. All right, well, that makes sense. I'll look into that. Turns out, it takes a long time. So when I left the US, which was in 2003, my brother was about 9, my sister was about 3 years old. So they can't do the process until they're 18 or 21, I'm not sure. So yeah, I had to wait a long time. They're at the proper age now, it's 2016. You know how many years it takes? It takes 15 years, if eligible. So if they put in the paperwork, it can take up to 15 years before the US says, all right, you could go ahead and come in the legal way. I'll be 45 in 15 years. So, right? That's something, I guess, right? But I'd rather see my mom now before she's super old and can't really do much. So yeah, your legal way sucks, Donald Trump. Now, I have no idea how you plan on sending 11 million people and having them do the legal way. I could only imagine how many years they're gonna have to wait. They're gonna lose their house, they're gonna lose their jobs, they're gonna lose family, they're gonna lose a lot of things trying to do it your legal way. Now, Does the legal way sound like a good idea to you? Doesn't sound like a good idea to me. Now, a lot of people say, well, why didn't your parents do it the legal way? I'll tell you why my parents didn't do it the legal way, because in order to do it the legal way, you have to have a good job. You have to have money in your bank account. You have to have properties, cars, good references. Now, the people leaving Mexico don't leave unless they have to leave. See, if you're rich in Mexico, you better damn well stay in Mexico, because Mexico is really good. We have it all. We have beaches. That's why you guys come out here for spring break. We have beaches. We have everything. We have stadiums. We have a lot of good stuff. The people that leave are the people that can't afford any of that. People that are getting paid 11 pesos per hour to work. That's shit. That means in a day they make enough to buy one pizza. Can you live on one pizza per day? And that's minus, you still have to pay your electric bill and your gas, which is not very cheap. You have to pay your water, you have to pay everything else, your taxes. It's not that easy. So the people that leave are usually not eligible. That's why they leave the illegal way. That's why they cross the border. They risk their life running through the desert, swimming the river, jumping over borders, going inside cars, getting kidnapped by drug lords, getting used as drug mules. It's not by choice. They have no more choice. They ran out of options and they want to do something for their family. That's why they leave illegally. Now, yeah, I understand you don't like us Mexicans taking your jobs, but do you really consider a janitor job your job? Or an onion picking job your job? Or working the shit jobs in the sun your job? When you had the chance to get an education, you had the proper chance to do something with your life, but you didn't. So now you're stuck with shit jobs that Mexicans are taking away. You're complaining because of that, because you were lazy? Sorry, I can't be on that side. I don't understand. If I had all the opportunities you guys did, if I had all the opportunities you guys had, I would have been something a lot greater. I would have been studying as much as possible. I would be a professional. I am a professional out here. I studied architecture. I don't know if I mentioned it, but yeah, that's what I think about your legal way in. Yes, there's a legal way in, but it's not an easy way in. So you should think of something better. Be a little less aggressive. Stop pointing them fingers. Next time you judge a Mexican, make sure you know his story. There's a lot of really good people out there. I know a lot of them. And I haven't seen my family in a long time. They're good people. So God bless everybody. And if you're going to vote for Donald Trump, I hope America does become great again. Because I remember there was something about dreams and equality and land of the free. There's a lot of the opposite going on. It's not a lot of freedom going on right now, but you guys enjoy. Big shout out from Mexico. I love Mexico. I don't want to leave Mexico. I just want to visit my family. But bye-bye, everybody. God bless America.